Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. So Lorna Shore has dropped yet another track for us. This one is called Curse to Die, and they have finally announced their brand new album. It's titled Pain Remains, and it's going to be out October 14th this year. I am super excited about that. I'm going to go ahead and call it Album of the Year. These guys have been putting out songs, not like nonstop bangers. They are killing it right now. Lorna Shore is absolutely killing the deathcore scene right now. And I love them. And I'm not even a huge deathcore fan. Like, if you've watched my channel for any amount of time, I've said it several times. I'm not a huge deathcore fan, but I absolutely love Lorna Shore. So we're going to go ahead and get into this video. It's Curse to Die. I apologize in advance if it's just a little screenshot down in the video here. Century Media blocks almost every music video that I put up, so I just have to replace it with a screenshot. So if that's what you're seeing, I apologize. Link to the original video down in the description. If you haven't already seen it, you can go check it out. But anyway, Curse to Die by Lorna Shore. Let's go ahead and jump into this video and check it out. I love how epic they always sound. Like, they're super heavy, super fast, super technical, but they always sound so just melodic and like emotional and just, I don't know. I love their melodies that they play under all of the, like, the heaviness and the fast stuff. It sounds so good all the time. Drummer is going absolutely insane, like nonstop. Jesus Christ. Oh, out of nowhere. My headphones just fucking exploded. That snare. Sound like a gunshot. We'll be right back. solo time. Let's go. Gotta pause it and talk about it. Oh, we're almost to the end of the song, but goddamn, man, his solos are so good all the time. I love the little flourishes and stuff he does with the whammy bar, and just it's always so melodic, and just the note selection is perfect. Like, it's fast, it's technical, it's very showy, it fits with the whole like sound of the heaviness, but it's melodic and like emotional at the same time, and I fucking love it. It's so good. Cursed to Die by Lorna Shore. Man, these guys just don't miss. Like every song, it just, they're so incredibly heavy, but so melodic and emotional and just epic, like, at the same time. And I can't get enough of it. They're so good. This is such an incredible band. And I know they've been around for a little while. I'm new to Lorna Shore. I'm new to really like deathcore in general, just kind of getting into Slaughter to Prevail and then Lorna Shore right after that. I'm new to the genre, really. So I know these guys have been around, and I'm sure they've always been awesome, but goddamn, like right now, I just feel like they are killing it, and I am super excited about this album. This was really, really good. I've already said it. I love how they're heavy, like heavy as shit and fast as shit, but just melodic and emotional, and just like, it's so good. It's just so good. And it's like the choruses are, I don't want to go as far to say as like catchy, like the choruses are catchy, but there's always like, even though there's all like the fast stuff, the screaming vocals, everything, like the band is going off, there's always like that bottom line like melody going on that makes it singable, I guess. Like, you can get it stuck in your head. And it hooks you. It hooks you. It's not just fast. It's for the sake of being fast and just like chaotic. It's not just that. There's a melody to it, and it's. I think that's what makes it easier to listen to, I guess. And I'm not saying Lorna Shore is easy listening by any means, but there's that melody there. It's not just like, you can't listen to this, and I know that some people still would, but you can't listen to this and say, oh, that's just noise. You can't do it, because there's that melody. You can clearly hear it if you just listen to it. I think it just draws you in. I think they have perfected that. I feel like they've perfected heaviness and with the melodic side, the emotional side. They do it perfectly. Like I said already a couple times in this video, I have not listened to a ton of deathcore, but the deathcore that I have listened to, I haven't heard a band like this, really, where they have that perfect mixture. And I think Lorna Shore is just, they're killing it right now. And I think that's why, I feel like that's why everybody loves them so much. Let's get into specifics of this song, Cursed to Die. I kind of like that they didn't end the song with a breakdown, because that's kind of like been their formula here for a little while. Is, you know, it's heavy, it's heavy, it's heavy, and it's fast and fast and fast, and then there's a solo, and then the end is just some like soul crushing breakdown. I like that they didn't do that in this one. They still had a breakdown, but it was in the middle and it was out of nowhere, and it's like, fuck, like I said my damn headphones exploded. It just like sounded awesome, just caught me completely off guard. But then instead of finishing with like another breakdown or another two or three fucking breakdowns, it was the solo and that like epic finish, kind of fade out or whatever. I love that. I don't want to, I guess, every time I listen to a Lorna Shore song, expect, oh, there's going to be a breakdown at the end. Oh, waiting on the breakdown. Because that can get, even though they sound awesome and they're just fucking heavy and just like you want to hear it, I feel like that can get stale after a while and lose the effect of the heavy-ass breakdowns. You don't want to put them at the end of every single song. But damn, this one's so good. That solo, I think that's my favorite solo I've heard from him so far. It's so good. So good. Just emotional, technical, melodic. I love the little flourishes he does with the whammy bar. Just adds just an extra little bit of like flavor to it. And his like personal style. It's awesome. These guys are killing it. I cannot wait on this album. So I was looking at the track list, and it looks like, somebody put it down here in the comments, the track list. So it looks like there's 10 tracks, I guess, from what I've seen. There's 10 tracks, but the last three tracks is actually split up into the three parts. It's the title track, Pain Remains, and it's like 20 and a half minutes, something like that. And then, like I said, it's split into three parts, so that's going to be an epic-ass song. It's gonna be awesome. And so we've already got three tracks from the album. What, Into the Earth, Sun Eater, and now Curse to Die. I wonder if they'll release another one before the album comes out. I hope they don't release too many more. Maybe one more as like a little extra teaser. But I don't want to hear like the whole album before it comes out. But this, like I said in the beginning of this video, I'm already going to call it like album of the year. These guys are killing it. And anyway, now I'm rambling on. I could sit here and talk about Lorna Shore all day, but you guys don't want to hear that, and I don't have time for that. So I'm going to get out of here. I appreciate you guys checking out the new song with me. Jump down in the comments. Let me know what you thought of it, and let me know if you're excited for the new album coming out in October. Of course you are. I already know. You don't have to tell me. I'm going to get out of here. I'll see you guys in the next video. All right. Bye.